Do you teach high school or college level physics, chemistry, or astronomy, or even light and color in middle school? Are you frustrated trying to teach the visible light spectrum, diffraction, or spectroscopy? Hi, my name is Tom Field, and I'm the founder of Field Tested Systems. I'm passionate about science, and I'm committed to helping teachers like you inspire their students to love learning science. In the past, you've had to rely on diffraction foil like this, or rainbow glasses like these, or cheap handheld spectrometers like this one. But you know how frustrating these tools are, and often they're nearly useless. Students spend too much time just trying to find the rainbow, and they often never see what you're trying to show them. Those tools are also 20th century. These days, students expect to use modern technology in everything that they do. But until now, the only alternative has been expensive devices that are way too complex and hard to use. I'm here to introduce you to a new, very affordable product that will revolutionize the way you teach these subjects. Our new RSpec-Explorer system is a point-and-shoot spectrometer. It comes out of the box, ready to use. There's no calibration, there's no adjustment needed. You just set it on your lab bench, plug it into your computer, and point it at a light source. And you can use it with any light source. For example, use gas tubes like this one, or use an LED column like this. The great thing about RSpec-Explorer is that you can use it with your overhead projector so everyone sees the same thing at the same time. For example, here's the system in actual use in a real classroom. There's the gas tube, and there's the camera. Notice the colorful spectrum and graph appearing live on the overhead projector. The students are attentive, engaged, instead of struggling with a piece of foil trying to see what their teacher is pointing out. Let's see how the RSpec-Explorer system works. So this is the screen of the software that comes with the system. And we can see in the view there, we have an LED column with just one light on right now, that violet light. We can see the dispersed light, and as we step through different colors into the greens and then yellows and then reds, we can see the dispersed light moving further and further away from the column until here we have all the lights on. This white LED here allows us to demonstrate that white light is composed of all the different colors, and when it's diffracted, shows up as a rainbow. Sir Isaac Newton would be happy to see this display. So now we can take the next step and do some quantitative spectroscopy. We'll drag this capture box around just a portion of the image. The software is going to just sample the data between those orange lines. So this peak over here is an intensity peak for the light itself. And this peak over here is the intensity peak for that violet light that we're seeing dispersed through the grating in the spectrometer. Now let's drag that capture box around a different portion of the spectrum, maybe up to here in the green. Now over on the right, we can see that our peak is in the green range at about 550 nanometers. Let's do one more over here. We'll slide up to the red, and we can see on the right that our peak is at the red end of the spectrum. So this is a great demonstration that shows how dispersion can be measured using a device like a spectrometer. Showing this in front of the class means that everybody's seeing the same thing and is following along. And now that students know what to look for, they can use foil devices to study the spectrum for a hands-on activity. Now let's look at another way that we can use the system to study, in this case, gas tubes. So here we have a gas tube that I'm going to turn on. This could be a demonstration in front of a class, or it could be a lab activity also. The first step, as we saw previously, is to drag these orange capture lines around the area that we want to study. Now, over on the right, we can see these peaks that correspond to the actual spectrum, once again making it clear how we can do quantitative spectroscopy off of a gas tube. So here's the fun part. We can now identify the type of gas tube. The software has a reference library built in, so when I select helium here, up on the graph we can see some reference lines indicating where the helium emission line should be. And we can see that our red data peaks don't line up with those reference lines at all. So we know this isn't a helium gas tube, but what about hydrogen? We've turned on the hydrogen bomber reference lines, and on the top here we can see that our data peaks line up with those reference lines overlaid as a template. So now we've identified this as a hydrogen gas tube. That's a really exciting activity and very easy to do with the software. Now for our next activity, we're going to do something a little different. We have an external slit here that comes with the system. You just set it up right on your lab bench and slide it together like this. Now behind it, we have just any old lamp illuminating it. Now we have here a lemon from the kitchen. We're just going to hold it behind the slit here. And over on the right, we can see that as expected, the peak is in the yellow range because this is a yellow object. There's all sorts of color studies that you can do with a system like this to help your students understand light and color. But let's look at another example. Instead of the lemon, we're going to turn off our backlight. And here on my cell phone, I'm going to display a screen that's all yellow. I'm using a color design program on my cell phone, but you could as easily just taken a picture of a yellow piece of paper or a lemon. When I hold the cell phone behind the slit, we can see even visually in the video display, there's a lot of green and there's a lot of red, but there's no yellow in the spectrum. Same thing quantitatively over on the right. We can see a green peak and we see a red peak. What's going on here? Well, of course, computer screens, whether they're cell phones or monitors, can't generate a pure yellow color. They have red, green, and blue, RGB emitters, and they generate some red and some green, and our eyes combine those and sees them as yellow. This is a great exercise and can even be used in student labs. In fact, the same technique can be used to study the gas flames of different materials doing flame spectroscopy. On the left here is a Bunsen burner. You can see the blue flame. Now remember, of course, that open flames can be dangerous. Be sure to adhere to standard safety practices. As we hold a sample of common table salt, sodium chloride, in the flame, we can see the emission spectrum here. And on the intensity profile graph, we can clearly see the emission line of the sodium doublet. Flame spectroscopy isn't quite as easy as gas tube spectroscopy, but as you can see here, it can be used to reveal the composition of a variety of materials. Okay, so now you've seen the power of the RSpec-Explorer system. Use it for demonstrations in front of your classroom or for hands-on student labs. It's easy to use, very affordable, and will totally transform your students' learning experience. And it not only helps you meet the next generation science standards, but it can help you be the teacher that your students will always remember.